So, I would like to begin today by asking you all to close one of your eyes. Now, raise your arms out in front of you and try to touch your two index fingers together. This is gonna look something like this. Now, as many of you will notice, this is not really an easy task. What you're experiencing is a lack of depth perception as a result of closing one of your eyes. Well, this is how I live my daily life. My name is Katarina Stephan, and I have one eye. Now, if you knew me in middle school, you may know me by my nickname, Three Eyes. You can do the math. The name comes from the humor of my clever classmates, in which needing glasses to see, but only having one eye, justified my name, Three Eyes. I was born with a rare congenital anomaly that left me virtually blind at birth. At 8, my left eye was surgically removed. At 9, I began wearing a prosthetic left eye. At 12, I met my ballet coach, Watmora Casey. He transformed my handicap into a strength. At 18, I trained with a professional ballet company in Austria. At 19, I taught cardiothoracic surgery and assisted in human heart procurements for transplants. Today, at 20, I stand before you to tell you a story of darkness and light, of physical eyesight and vision. My life demonstrates that living with one eye can be very similar to your life with two, and that the information that I have learned along the way to compensate for my vision loss is translatable to your life. Mental visualization, proprioception, and motion parallax are three nuances that exist and demonstrate the power of our bodies and minds. First, let me clarify what vision is not. Our purely physical eyesight, which we rely on above all other senses, does not always provide an accurate picture of our world. Now, to demonstrate this, I am going to need your help. In this optical illusion, how many of you see the female dancer in the center, rotating clockwise? How many of you see her rotating counterclockwise? Well, as you can tell, we do not all agree. In the center image, there is a lack of visual depth cues, which is causing our brains to interpret the image differently. Our eyes are therefore not responsible for everything that we are visually experiencing. In dreams, for example, our brains can generate a visual experience without any sensory input from our eyes. Likewise, if I asked you to visualize what a glass car looks like, you would have no problem visualizing one, although you have never actually seen one. Vision involves the construction of a mental image of our external world. Our purely physical eyesight is not as reliable as we assume, but our internal vision, generated in our mind, compensates for the illusion of pure physical eyesight. The exercise of mentally visualizing a glass car serves as a brief introduction to the mental visualization that has served as my internal guide. When training for my ballet career, I had to learn to compensate for not having two eyes. In order to achieve the impeccable balance needed on pointe shoes, I learned to close my eyes as I danced. I created a mental representation of each movement as if I were truly performing in a virtual body in my mind. In doing so, I was able to achieve that balance in my virtual body and translate that information to my physical body in space. However, I did not only see these corrections, I felt them too. At 16, I contracted a near-fatal infection that left me in a wheelchair for months. Doctors told me I would never dance again. So, I danced with the virtual body in my mind instead. I visualized and mentally felt every muscle activation required to perform with the virtual body in my mind. In doing so, I never really stopped dancing. I did what astronauts do when training in zero gravity conditions to prevent muscle atrophy. My mind activated my muscles. 1 year later, I returned to ballet. after a remarkably fast recovery, proved my doctors wrong, and performed with a professional ballet company in Austria. I succeeded as a ballerina because of my heightened awareness to mental visualization, but also my awareness to my proprioception. Proprioception is an awareness of our bodies in space, an awareness to where each part is relative to one another. Proprioception is what allows us to move and react to our external environment without using our eyes. We all use proprioception. For example, close your eyes. Raise your index finger to your nose. If you are able to do so, then you have just located your nose in space using proprioception. This is a sense that is so informative that it can serve as a third eye, or in my case, a second eye. We all have the ability to strengthen our own proprioception through mind-body exercises. For example, performing daily tasks with your eyes closed enhances that brain-body communication. My awareness to mental visualization and my ability to apply this and proprioception to complex tasks gave me the second eye I needed to perform surgery. At Stanford, I was a teaching assistant in a cardiothoracic surgical simulation lab. I performed surgeries such as septum defect repairs and coronary artery bypasses. Initially, I was slower than my peers. However, over time, I began to memorize the delicate feel of the body tissue, the weight of the surgical instrument, and the feeling of my hand welding the instrument upon the body tissue. In doing so, I was able to keep up. I used my mental visualization to imagine where I should be within the simulated body cavity and confirmed this by the feeling that I was having. In doing so, I executed these surgeries without relying on my vision. I began this talk by asking you all to close one of your eyes. This was to demonstrate a lack of depth perception as a result of only having one eye. An individual with two eyes aligns him or herself in space so that the third dimension can be seen. Each eye is responsible for generating an image, and it is the brain's responsibility to intercept these images into one and subsequently create a third dimension. However, in theory then, an individual with one eye should not be able to see the third dimension. However, I do so, and I do in two ways. In the first method, I use time rather than space. This is called motion parallax. My eye captures one image and engraves it into my mind, and then I move my head ever so slightly to capture a second image taken a split second apart. In doing so, my brain can interpret these photos and create the third dimension. We all use motion parallax. In this example, we are able to tell that the pillars are closer in proximity to us than the brick wall. This is because the pillars are moving at a faster speed relative to the brick wall. Therefore, we are using time and motion rather than space to determine depth perception. In the second method that I use to generate the third dimension, I use my senses, specifically proprioception. It is this sixth sense that gave me the power to perform both on stage and in the operating room. When I was 4, the doctors took the eye patch off my single good eye. Light and color flowed into my life. When doctors told me I would never dance again, darkness flooded my life. When 6 months later my mother passed away, I thought I would never see the light again. Moving from a wheelchair to dancing on stage, I began to see the light again. Moving to Austria to then dance with a ballet company, only to realize that ballet is not my true vocation, darkness flooded in again. Finally, when I internalized the voice of my mother and returned to America to pursue a career in academia, I attended Columbia University now as a student. And I am continuing to chase the light. Today, I continue to chase this light. I am an EMT with Columbia University Emergency Medical Services, and I drive their ambulance in New York City with just one eye. I have recently met doctors in Boston who are engineering visual prostheses that have the capacity to restore vision to the blind. I will personally assist them this summer by providing user interface to their medical devices. I fully intend on chasing light and color for every blind person in this world. Mental visualization, proprioception, and motion parallax are three internal guides that testify to the power of our bodies and minds. These innate abilities manifest in other species as well. For example, dogs use their acute sense of smell to navigate the world. Bats use echolocation, and birds can detect the Earth's electromagnetic field. These internal guides are exceptionally powerful. I urge you not only to become aware, but to utilize them, especially in times of trial. Remember that when life gets difficult, you have two options: to focus your awareness on your external or internal vision. Let this internal guide let the light in. Go out into this world, pay it forward, and chase color. Thank you.